Alright, this hand is slow, but I think it's okay against him. And it's got a scry. And a decent amount of lands, three lands, and all of our colors. Can't cast like a Boros, whatever. Not actually sure what deck he is. I boarded like he was mono black, but he very easily could be just some weird deck I've never seen before. So I'm just gonna lead off with Sacred Foundry here. Again, I don't really know what I want to draw. The one exception would be Precinct Captain. I would love to draw Precinct Captain, but the chances of that being relevant off this turn is pretty low. Put this on the bottom. We have two more lands. We do have a five drop in our hand, but we got plenty of time to get there, I think. And we're gonna have Nykthos to help us get there, potentially. That was really good. You could say Heliod or this. The card's pretty strong against us, but not broken. Like, it's not like it is against, like, I don't know, green white. I guess actually not that good against green white. Because all the guys are probably cheaper than white. Right now, he's choosing between these two. A lot of people, when they play this, will not realize that Heliod is an option because not a lot of people play the white god. But on Modo, it's pretty obvious because it highlights the two selections. We do have a martial law, which will stop that life drain zombie. That's kind of nice. All right, I think he correctly chose Boros Arcanine there. And we drew a Boros Arcanine because we are the best. Which is good because we probably didn't want a second one. If I had to be completely honest with you. If we did, it would be strictly for devotion purposes. Not gonna play this yet, just in case he has something weird. Just gonna play the Martial Law. Gonna leave my Boros Reckoner back just to hold off these two Mutavaults. Alright, just take a whack on the noggin from that thing. Okay. That won't be a problem because Assembled Legion will answer that. So this turn, it's clearly better to lock this down because it's more damage, unless I was going to sack something, which I don't think I am. So I have 5, 7 mana. Not exactly the amount that I would like. I think I just play. Play this. No, it doesn't work. This gets me another. Both these get me there, actually. Then the turn after, I could do both. Yeah, I think I just hold back on the Nykthos, play this. Take three this turn, then I can lock this thing out for forever with Assembled Legion. He has removal here for Boros Reckoner, that'd be big. Does he have another demon? Okay, so he does. So that's big, but I don't actually need. Oh, sorry, Kobe, etc. So you survive for one more turn, I think. Drawing a Chain of the Rocks would be huge here. So I just play this tapped and play Heliod, I guess. Taking six this turn potentially. If he has removal for this, I also take take a bunch and I die. This is all relying on this guy to survive. But it took him a while to find removal for the Reckoner. In Hero's Downfall. Also, if he uses removal... No, if he uses removal, I'm dead. He would have to be only to activate one Mutavault to not kill me. Which is a very slim chance of. So now this nets me mana. So this is like two land drops. So I can play Purphoros and make... A dude. Just activate the third one, please. Don't kill my guy. Okay, so I'm going to three. That's scary, but it's manageable. If I draw a white permanent, this becomes active and it gets a lot easier. I forged Mutavault, jeez. Ooh. What does that do for me? Not much. So I think I just do this and make a guy. I might just have to make two guys, actually. Sack, block, block. Yeah, I don't even know if I could play Purphoros here. Wait, what? Did I click the wrong mana color? We have four white devotion. Okay, there we go. I was so scared for a second. I obviously can't attack with any of these things. Oh, I could actually. Vigilance. No, I forgot about vigilance. Okay, I missed two damage. Probably three. No, two damage. Forgot about vigilance. Gotta remember that. New card. Don't play with this one too often. I would say this is probably the worst god. This the green one is, I think, better because of how easier green is to get devotion or how much easier it is to synergize. Although this ability is probably better. Yeah, I'm not sure. Pointless. Regardless, I missed 2 points of damage there. Haste plus... A, these guys have haste, which I forgot, and B, they have vigilance. I forgot it all. But I'm slowly climbing out of this hole. Assemble the Legion. If he has a Grey Merchant anywhere in his deck, I am dead. The deadest of deads. But Purphoros is going to kill him very quickly. I can tell you that much. I know from experience. The first time these guys come into play, yeah, that two damage can be huge. He's not doing anything. Okay. So now I can't attack with the 1/1s. I can't attack with these guys. Because they would just eat a Mutavault. Last breath is reasonable. Alright, so. Guess I just play this. Alright, so attack both these guys. I can last breath to stay alive, even. That's pretty sweet. When he's getting ultimate priced. Couldn't attack with the 1/1s this time because he could block Mutavaults. So I can actually, if he plays Grey Merchant, I can actually last breath one of my things to stay alive. So. Unless he plays another black permanent first, of course, but. Can't do much about that. Yeah, he's actually just dead next turn. He's gonna be dealt 8 off of between the. Oh no, he's gonna be dealt 8 from this and 2 from this. That's 10. Oh, he drew something that might keep him alive. Pretty sure I make a dude here. I gotta do this. Dome you, bro. I'm gonna get domed for 8 right now. Yeah, I'll just target this just to make sure. Spear of Heliod is pretty good, I would say. My devotion to white is now 6, or is it 5? No, it's 6. So this guy can attack. So I can make 6 white, a red, make a dude. Okay. Imagine this is game with my pump and everything. Oh yeah, he's just taking 1 million. He's not even bother blocking. All right, sweet. So I don't really know what his deck was. It basically played out like mono black. Do we even see any white cards now that I think about it? I wonder. Who did this play against? What was his name? Arrester. Get the scoop for you guys. Oh, I don't want to yell at him. Find out what white cards he had in his deck if he had any. See if I got a response or not. I was just curious, just because he seemed like a mono black deck, so I'm curious what things he had in there. If he was running like. Okay, just Last Breath, Elspeth. So he's just a mono black deck splashing white. I've seen decks that run things like Renounce the Guilds. Renounce the Guilds and other things of that nature, but he was just mono black with probably Blood Baron, Last Breath, and Elspeth. But yeah, so it plays out very similarly. I think we sideboarded correctly. The one problem with our sideboarding was that we took out Mortars, which does deal with Blood Baron, whereas I didn't think about that at the time, and Chains doesn't, and Helix doesn't, and Last Breath doesn't. So I should have had some number of mortars in. I think I left 2 in, so because I did one in my hand that game. So I think it was reasonable. And outside of that, we can also. I don't think we can block with any of our tokens, now that I think about it. They're all white as well. So yeah, basically Purphoros still here to block him, which is not that efficient. So definitely make sure we keep answers to Blood Baron in, because he could be a problem. And outside of that, I think we play that matchup pretty standard. So, all right. I'm out of here, and we'll be back with some more with this deck. I'll continue to tune it and hopefully play with the tune. And I'll see you guys later.